Following their victory over Custer at the Little Bighorn in 1876, Native Americans could not escape retribution by the U.S. government, and by the 1880s, many tribes that once roamed freely on the plains had submitted to the government policy of mass resettlement on reservations rather than face extinction. Once on the reservation, Native Americans were forced to assimilate into white culture. Indian children were taken from their families and sent to boarding schools to be stripped of their language, spirituality, and the only way of life they had known. Children were taught English and to read and write, and to act and dress as white children. But as Native Americans, they found it difficult to be accepted into white society, and were caught between two conflicting worlds. It was in this time that the story of Zitkala-Sa begins.
I was born Gertrude Simmons on the Yankton Sioux Reservation in South Dakota. In my early childhood, I was free as the wind and no less spirited than a bounding deer. Our teepee stood at the base of some hills. Many a summer afternoon, a party of four or five of my playmates roamed over the hills with me. We delighted in impersonating our mothers. I remember how we used to exchange our necklaces, beads, and sometimes even our moccasins. We pretended to offer them as gifts to one another. In the lap of the prairie, we sat and told stories of heroic deeds performed by relatives. When we grew tired of our games or stories, we always returned to chasing the great shadows that played among the hills.
Gertrude's Yankton path was changed when missionaries visited her village. She was 8 years old, and the men had come to take the children to boarding school in the East. Gertrude wanted to visit the land where sweet red apples grew on the trees. From the window of the train, she saw her land and family vanish in the distance, and regret soon settled upon her.
I remember the day I lost my spirit. It was not when we reached the school grounds. It was not when my native clothes were taken away and replaced with a dress that scratched my skin and hard shoes that pinched my feet. It was the next morning when I overheard talk of cutting my long, heavy hair. I did my best to hide, but I was found. Strong hands carried me down the stairs and tied me fast to a chair. I cried and shook my head wildly until I felt the cold blades of the scissors against my neck. Then my keepers gnawed off my thick braids and cut my hair in a shingle style that labeled me as a coward. I lost my spirit that day. I could not know that it would rise again, stronger and wiser for the wounds that it had suffered.
Redbird Sings, the story of Zitkala-Sa, Native American author, musician, and activist, follows Gertrude Simmons as she tries to reconcile the two conflicting worlds in which she must live.